Well, where to begin? Officer Nanny was someone who's not only near and dear to our department, but near and dear to our community. He's been with the department over 10 years now. The last 3 years, he's been the school resource officer at the Blaine High School, one of our high schools here, where he's been. He really is a part of that community as well. He has impacted so many of the young people there and our youth, and this was something he really had a passion for doing, was for working with the kids there, and he really was able to connect with them. And really, even now as we go into summer, he's still having contact virtually daily with many of the kids there. He had a heart of gold. He really was just a kind person who would do anything he could to help people out, but he was very genuine as well. And just soft-spoken, yet resolute, and just really a nice person, not only a phenomenal officer. In addition to being involved as a school resource officer, he was also our department's Special Olympics representative, where he was dedicated a lot of time to the Special Olympics program in a number of different capacities, including this Friday. He was supposed to be running our leg of the torch run going through our city here. And he was just tireless in his efforts there.
What was his personality like?
You know, he was, he kind of had a dry charm and wit. He, a very kind, like I said, soft-spoken person. One of those, you know, as I said, he had been here 10 years. He was kind of a friend to everyone, really was. And not just within the department, but people in the community, as I mentioned, the schools, but other places in the community. If you look at, you know, we've put some things out on social media about this tragedy, and if you look at some of the comments in there from some of our community members and some of the kids in the community, it just really tells the kind of person he was. You know, he took his job seriously, but not always himself. He was never afraid to laugh at himself. And again, just a very kind, patient, soft-spoken person.
What was your reaction to hearing about what happened?
We were awestruck. We really were. We were contacted last night and heard what had happened. I personally had just talked to him the night before, and I don't think you're ever ready for anything like that. But certainly in such a tragic fashion as well. Steve and Susie, as his wife was known, and we call Steve Lou Nanny sometimes, but Steve and Susie were, if you knew Steve, you knew Susie, his wife. They were together all the time, and both just wonderful people. And to know one was to know the other. And, you know, we try to find silver linings in tragedy. And to know that they were together, they didn't suffer. And up to the end, it's just, it helps bring us some comfort. But it's also, it's painful too. You know, we're hurting here as a department. We're hurting as a community. And we'll get through. You know, we have a strong community here in Blaine, and we have a lot of support from other people in that community, including the school. And we know we'll get through, but it is painful. It's painful to lose someone and lose someone in a tragic, unexpected fashion. We know that they died doing something they really enjoyed doing. They loved it. This was one of their passions. They loved to travel. They loved motorcycling. They loved the outdoors. And to know that they were able to do something they loved and that they went together brings us some comfort.
Do they have children?
They don't have children. And originally they're both from Missouri. And so most of their family members are in Missouri. Prior to working here at the Blaine Police Department, where he's been for 10 years, Officer Nanny did work in Baldwin, Missouri. And then he was also an officer in Utah shortly before he came to Blaine. But he's been part of our Blaine family for quite a while. So.
Are you guys doing anything in his honor and remembrance, memorial?
We will be. We are still assessing that. It's early yet. We want to work with the family and do everything we can to support their families who are on their way up here now. And that's where our first priority is right now, is taking care of them and helping them. But we do plan to do things as a community And we're still working those out. As we figure out what those will be, we'll certainly let the community know what we're going to do and invite them to participate in that as well. Yep. First name is Brian, B-R-I-A-N. Last name is Padani, P-O-D-A-N-Y. And I'm the Safety Services Manager and Police Chief for the City of Blaine.
I'm sorry for your loss.
Thank you very much. We appreciate that. And, you know, we having the support at a difficult time like this, it truly does help. It helps our staff and it helps our community to know that, you know, even though we no longer have them, we have their spirit, and they were involved.
Do you have a favorite memory?
Oh, boy, where to begin? You know, some of my favorite memories, we all have comical memories as well, but one of my favorite memories has to do with the work that he did with our youth. As part of the work in our high schools, we do an Arrive Alive program. We do a mock crash and to educate kids about the dangers of impaired and distracted driving and just to educate them about safe driving habits. Well, part of Steve's role at Blaine High School was to coordinate and put together that program, and this really is a heavily involved program that he had done. And to see that, we had just done this maybe a month ago, this was very recently, to see the connection that he had with the kids, this was for all of the juniors and seniors at the high school, and how he put that program together and the passion and work that he put into that program was amazing. It really was. And to see the impact and to hear from the kids how much that has changed their lives and how he has changed their lives, you know, we know that his life was not in vain, that he truly did make a difference for our kids and our community and for our community as a whole. He did not live in Blaine. He's just outside of Blaine.
Are you saying that his wife also passed away?
His wife passed away in the crash as well. They were both on the same motorcycle.
Was he even driving?
He was driving, yes. He was driving and involved another vehicle. I don't have a lot of the details on the crash. That would be for the Elk River Police Department to answer. His wife was an associate professor at the University of Minnesota, and where she worked with things pertaining to nutrition with children and diabetes. And I think she actually had a fellowship in D.C. in December as well. So just both wonderful people. So big hit to our community as well as theirs.
And you've got the black on your badge, or is this?
Yeah, this is something we'll be doing. Even though this is not a line of duty death, we do still want to honor one of our own fallen, which we will be wearing our mourning bands through the duration of the services for Steve.
Thank you.
I just need shots and stuff.
Thank you. Thank you for coming out. And, we hope to pay his life tribute and her life. Like I said, if you knew one, you knew the other. They were connected all the time. Both just genuine people. You know, I honestly don't, Sarge. Do you know that offhand? Yeah, I apologize. I don't. But I know they, as I indicated, they're both from Missouri. I think they were high school sweethearts, if I'm not mistaken. Or at least they knew each other in high school. And so they've known each other a long time. So, they've been through a lot, and they had a lot of adventures. I learned this morning. I knew they liked to travel, but they made it to 6 of 7 continents.
Uh-huh.
We should all be so fortunate. You know? So, absolutely.
Did his wife share the same last name?
So yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, and her Nanny, N-A-N-N-E-Y. And she went by Susie, but her first name was actually Marilyn. So.
Oh.
But she went by Susie. So.
Thanks for the time.
Thank you. Oops,
absolutely.
I apologize.
Okay. All right.